Deep in the heart of Africa, the mighty Congo River navigates its path with unparalleled force. It's the deepest river in the world, at over 700 feet deep, and carries more water than any river except the Amazon River, plunging dramatically over the Inga Falls near Kinshasa in DR Congo. For decades, the DRC has looked at this untamed power, seen as a key to unlocking Africa's future. In this latest video by Africa Rebound, we tell the story of the Grand Inga Dams Project, a dream of monumental scale, huge potential, and immense complexity. This is a project that could transform the Democratic Republic of Congo and power the entire African continent, but one that seems tantalizingly out of reach. The project vision is simple, yet breathtaking. Harness the immense hydropower potential of the Congo River at the Inga site. The first steps were taken in the 1970s and 80s with the construction of Inga 1 Dam, with an installed capacity of 351 megawatts, and Inga 2 Dam, with an installed capacity of 1,424 megawatts. The Grand Inga project refers to the full development of the site, primarily focusing on Inga 3 and the subsequent Grand Inga phases, Inga 4, Inga 5, Inga 6, and Inga 7. The scale of the Grand Inga vision is almost beyond comprehension. Studies consistently estimate the total technically feasible potential to be around 45,000 megawatts. To put this in perspective, that's roughly twice the capacity of China's Three Gorges Dam, the world's largest operating power station. And it represents over one-third of the total electricity currently generated across the entire African continent. Inga 3 Bass Shoot, or BC, is the most advanced proposed phase, originally conceived as a 4,800 megawatts project. Grand Inga, from phases 4 through to 7, would involve building massive dams further upstream to fully exploit the site's potential, pushing towards the 45,000 megawatt mark. This requires unprecedented regional cooperation and financing. When realized, the economic benefits of Grand Inga could be transformative. For the DR Congo, electricity exports could become a significant source of government revenue. Conservative estimates suggest that the Grand Inga could generate billions of dollars annually from exports to South Africa and other African nations. Reliable, affordable electricity from the Grand Inga 3 is essential for mining, since the DRC holds vast mineral wealth like cobalt and copper. Power-intensive processing could move into the DRC, creating jobs and capturing more value. The mining sector could save over $500 million annually by switching to grid hydropower. Manufacturing would also benefit, powering factories and creating millions of jobs. Universal access to electricity is another major benefit. Currently, only around one quarter of the DRC population has access to electricity, with the rural areas dropping to only 1%. Grand Inga provides the foundation for nationwide electrification, boosting education, healthcare, and quality of life. The Grand Inga will require massive infrastructure like dams, transmission lines, and roads. Therefore, developing it will spur construction, create skilled jobs, and position the DRC as Africa's energy center. And for Africa at large, Grand Inga could help solve the continent's chronic power shortage. The Grand Inga could supply large-scale, baseload, renewable power to multiple countries at the same time. Reliable and interconnected power grids attract investment continent-wide, boosting economic growth. Abundant hydropower enables energy-intensive industries, such as green steel, aluminum, or hydrogen production, to flourish in Africa and drive sustainable economic development. However, the path to realizing Grand Inga is fraught with immense hurdles. The estimated project costs for the Grand Inga Hydro Project range from $100 billion to well over $120 billion, requiring unprecedented international collaboration and funding. Various consortia have been proposed, involving Chinese firms like China Three Gorges and Sinohydro, Spanish companies like ACS, and French firms such as EDF, but none have reached financial close. The World Bank has historically been involved, but has become very cautious. Other key financiers could include the Development Bank of Southern Africa, the European Investment Bank, and potentially the BRICS New Development Bank. Private investment is essential, but investors remain wary. Anchor customers, like South Africa's Eskom, are crucial for Inga 3 exports, but Eskom itself is financially strained. The project faces major challenges, from the DR Congo's history of conflict. Governance issues create significant investor risk. Securing tens of billions in debt and equity for a project in a high-risk country is extremely difficult, so risk guarantees are essential. Furthermore, building the thousands of kilometers of high-voltage power lines required to export electricity across Africa, say to Nigeria or Egypt, for example, is a multi-billion dollar project in itself. And that's in addition to the complex regional agreements required to enable such exports. Securing long-term power purchase agreements and navigating complex inter-country politics add yet another layer of difficulty. The Grand Inga Dams Project embodies both the immense potential and the profound challenges facing Africa. Its scale is unmatched, offering the promise of clean and abundant power to drive industrialization, lift millions out of poverty, and achieve economic prosperity. Grand Inga remains a sleeping giant with its potential still waiting to be unleashed. Its awakening will depend not just on the flow of the Congo River, but on the flow of political will, transparent governance, regional cooperation, and global commitment. When these currents finally converge, Grand Inga could truly become the powerhouse that lights up Africa's future. May God bless the DRC, and may God bless Africa. Thanks for watching.